So today, we have a different scenarios to set up our lab. So the concept is snapshots. Today our concept is snapshots. How the snapshots will work and so what is the scenario we are making now? So first of all, what is a snapshot? So snapshot is a point in time backup of your instance or volume. That is called snapshot. So how it will helpful for us? Snapshot in instances. So let's take an example. I have a web server one. So now I'm installing some applications inside the web server one. Do you have any guarantee that application will give you the good result? No, right? Sometimes we will get some issues also. So what will happen in this case? After installing the application, it created some issues inside the server. It's not properly working and it will affect the production. The users will complain and will receive a priority 1 and priority 2 tickets, and we are managing them. So these type of issues will raise it normally. So guys, I'll ask you a question. The same scenario, you're working as a Windows administrator. Okay, so you are installing some applications on the Windows boxes. So what are the precautions you will take care of it before installing it?
Virus-free application.
Sorry?
Application should be
checking for the...
Okay, yes. So before installing the application, we will check virus-free. That will be, we will scan the application. You have any virus infected software or not? Is it clean or not? Is there any malware will be sitting on the applications? We'll check that. Yes or no? So mostly we will be testing a development environment, then will be UAT environment, user accept and test. That is called stage environment. Finally, they will be deploying in a production environment. So development, stage and production. So this is the three steps you will follow when we are installing any new applications to the production. This is correct, right? So even though after installing an application, there is a chance for corrupting an application on the production boxes. So for that reason, before installing anything, okay, after installed, you feel that application is good and the server is need a backup. You can take a option called snapshot facility. You can create a snapshot. So that means that will give you backup of a point in time of your instance. So let's take a, I'm creating a scenario for you guys. Please check it. So let me connect to the web server one first. This is the IP address. connect. Username is administrator. Password. So I successfully connected the server with the username and password. So I feel that the server is looking good. I don't have any issues here. Okay. I feel that I want to take a backup of this instance. What I will do, select the server, go to actions, go to actions. So now these are the options will be available at present. Okay. Now the instance, the backend, which is related to Elastic Block, we have a snapshot option and create a snapshot. So we have to select the snapshot source. So do you want to take a snapshot for volume? So volume means what? Volume means what?
EBS.
The drive, right? EBS volume for the instance, right? The EBS volume of the instance. Say example, the volumes at present are the 30 GB. So now can check the server in the desktop. I didn't install any application. Yes or no? It's a fresh machine. You feel that you ought to take a backup. So now we are in snapshot. Either you want to take a volume backup or instance backup. Instance means all the settings of the instance will get it. There is a instance type, all the settings will get it. So volume means only the drive will be taking a backup. Which one you want? So guys, I will take both example. One is a volume, another one is instance. Both I will take example. Understood? So now first, I'll take a volume. Select the volume. So this is a web server one. The volume is there. So ending with a 3071. You can check here. 3071. Selecting here. And do you want to give any description? Web server one. Volume. Snapshot. This is the description I'm providing. Do you want to provide any name for the key after creating the snapshot? So better I will give the same name. Web server one volume snapshot. Create a snapshot. Close it here. Snapshot is creating now. Please wait. Successfully, snapshot is created. Okay, snapshot is created. Now can go to volumes. Volumes still remain same, no changes at all. So now I'm installing some applications inside this machine. So let's go to Google Chrome, sorry, Internet Explorer. to disable the internet enhanced security configuration from server manager. Now I can open Internet Explorer. I'll install Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome. Anything I will install. Okay. Yeah, I'll install Google Chrome. Yeah, successfully Google Chrome is installed. See here, Google Chrome is installed on this machine. So my this server has got some problem after install the Google Chrome. So what we'll do? Do you have any recovery option? So we have to go for adder remove program and install it. So might be the adder remove program also not help us for uninstalling the program from the ARP. So what we'll do? So we need a backup to restore the instance. So let me show you with the snapshot. With the snapshot, how could I recover the operating system completely? So without a Google Chrome. So because of the, I have a snapshot is already available. Okay. So anyone have any questions? I move to next step. So let's select the snapshot, go to actions. Now by using the snapshot, create a image. What is image we have to create? The same web server one volume snapshot. So can give the name AMI. AMI means Amazon machine image. AMI stands for Amazon machine image. So now the same configuration for 30 GB, there is an operating system readily will be created in the AWS cloud. Okay, now just click create. It will take some time. It will take some time to create this AMI. So where it will be available, our operating system. So now in the left side, we have images. Under that images, we have AMIs. So currently AMI is created. So what is the name you are providing this? So we just give this information, the same name. Okay. So the AMI currently available. From this AMI, you can create directly instance, new instance. Understood? Or else you can go to instances, launch instance. Launch instance, we have in the left side my AMIs. Click on my AMI. See AMI web server one volume snapshot. So So we created now. We can select next. What configuration you want? Next. Settings, storage, tags. So now this I use it for web server 2. Web server 2. Existing security group, launch Windows 7 PM view instances. So now I have a web server 1 and web server 2. So web server 1, initially we have taken snapshot, after that we install Google Chrome. So the snapshot itself we converted to AMI, from that AMI we created instance. So instance is creating now. So please wait next 3 minutes to connect to the server. It will maximum wait for 4 minutes. So please wait it.
Hello.
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, before installing Google Chrome, you did some settings in Server Manager.
Okay, that is Internet Enhanced Security Configuration. So when we are opening the browser, so yeah. I open Google, right? So it got a prompt, a small prompt, it got it, right? So it will always get it in Windows for security reason. So that option is only available in security option in server, so we disable it maximum. Okay. So in the desktop operating system we don't see that option.
Okay, got it.
So let me connect to the server, web server 2. Still it is there. So even this is also one of the issue. So sometimes when we creating an instance from the Amazon machine image, so there's a custom AMIs, we'll get this kind of issues. So even that also I'll show you how to resolve the issue. Okay. This is a known issue in AWS. So this is a way how to resolve the issue. I'll let you know, because of still I'm waiting for the 4 minutes time is taking or not. Okay, if more than 4 minutes or 5 minutes are crossed, still we are getting the same message, so want to wait for 4 minutes and all, so that's a problem with the ID. Okay. So maximum I'll try next 1 minute. We'll wait. If this is not happen, so I will delete the web server too. I'll do the same steps once again. So let me try to connect. Yeah, this is the issue. So I'm deleting the web server to terminate the server. So this is a problem with the RSA that is called the key pair issue. So how to resolve the issue, I'll show you now. So once again, I'll go to back to the snapshot, AMI, delete the AMI first, that is called deregister. Go to snapshots, delete the snapshot, perfect. Now, in this situation, we have a Google Chrome, so I feel that Google Chrome is good, so I'm taking a backup. Before going to take a backup, so you want to set a custom password for a Windows operating system. Custom password. That means you should not depend for a key pair password. So please change your password accordingly. How to change the password normally in Windows? Go to Start, Control Panel, change account type, click on Administrator. Change password. So current password, what is the current password? I paste it. So new password is welcome@123, W is capital. So now I changed the password successfully. So next step, go to snapshots, create a snapshot, volume, select here, is a tag I'm providing, create a snapshot. So the snapshot is depends upon the data inside the volume. For the instance, it'll take some time. At present, even though 30 GB the data, so it is not completely used 30 GB. Approximately 14 GB or 15 GB, less than 20 GB only. So even the snapshot also took same size. But guys, don't create a multiple snapshots because of it will consume your storage space. So again, it will be charged in your billing cycle. So please aware of that. So whatever the storage is, it will be calculated for you in the bill. So now by using the snapshot, I'm creating an image. Close it. Go to AMIs. So select the AMI and launch it. When I click on launch, it will directly taking this add tax. So this time I am giving web server 3, okay, security group. So instance is creating now, so it will take at least minimum more than 1 minute. The server will be ready to connect. Copy the IP address. I think still server is preparing in the backend hypervisor. Please wait. Administrator. Password is welcome@123 W is capital. See, I'm connecting web server 3. I'm connecting web server 3 with the backup of web server 1. See, automatically the Google Chrome also it's updating. Understand? So we got a Google Chrome also. By default, we are not receiving a Google Chrome, right? So with the help of snapshot, we are creating a new instance with the existing snapshot file. Okay? Any questions?
What you did with the key pair the password?
I used a welcome@123. So now this time I'm using only the custom password. Keypair also it will work. Keypair also it will work. But custom password only we can log in.
Okay.
Understood. Good question. Thank you. Thanks for reminder. Otherwise, we have one more solution. Same custom image, we can launch instance. Okay, I'm not creating, just I'll show you. Next, 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 next. When you click on launch, do not select the key pair. We have option called proceed without a key pair option. Okay, proceed without key pair option, because your operating system already you have a custom password, we are using that. Understood?
Okay.
So thanks for reminding that. So even so, this topic also we cover it. So without password also we are creating instance because of the existing EMI, we already custom password we already set. So do you have an idea? So what is the use of snapshot? So from the volume yeah. perspective, we are taking the backup with the snapshot facility. From the snapshot, we are converted to EMI. From the EMI, we are creating a new instance. Got it? So guys, one more method we are going to take it. I'll go to snapshot once again. So this time, create a snapshot instance model. Okay, creating a instance. So when we are selecting this instance or volume, what's the difference means? When you select the instance, you will get an option called exclude root volume. Exclude root volume. What is meaning of root volume? C drive. Okay. If entire your virtual machine you are taking, you don't want a C drive as a backup. So the C drive will be excluded. But I'm not using this option. I have only one drive. So for that reason, I'm taking entire one. So which one I need to take instance? I don't know. First, I need to check the instance ID for web server one. Instance ID is a 4DD. So I'm selecting 4DD. So web server one instance snapshot. Okay. Copy it. Add tag. Create a snapshot. That's it. So snapshot is created. Yeah, snapshot is created. So the first snapshot I'm deleting now. I don't want that. So first the AMI I need to deregister.
Delete the AMI.
Yes. So now using the web server one instance snapshot, okay, I'm going to create an image. I'm going to create an image. What is the image I'll be creating now? Web server one instance snapshot, AMI underscore. Click on create. Close it. So AMI is created. So now click on launch instance. Next. 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 Web server 4. Next security group. Use existing security group. Select here. review launch. Now this time I'll be selecting proceeding without keypad. View instances. Yep, so web server 4 is ready now. We'll connect now. Go to run. I'm connecting. So what's the difference between instance and instance snapshot and volume snapshot? Any idea? Anyone can give me an example for that? What is the difference between volume snapshot and instance snapshot? Any idea?
With the volume snapshot, I guess we can do a backup for the all the data we have in the server. And with the instance snapshot, we just make a snapshot of the existing server.
That's correct. The second one is correct, but first one is not complete sentence. Let me explain. So volume snapshot, which will help us the drive level backup. Example, I need only D drive, E drive, F drive. So that type of level of backup will be provided, the volume snapshot. Instance snapshot is it will give you the complete existing server configuration. Okay. So within the short span of time, we can creating a new server and we can add it into the pool. Understand? Even have any issues, big issue also, don't worry. Okay? So if you have a snapshot, we will taking it. So any more questions here? Let's move to the another feature. Okay. Elastic block storage.
Yeah, I have one.
Yes, please.
If we delete the existing server, then the snapshot server will delete it by itself, or it will stay as a backup?
Okay. So your question is, if the server is deleted, okay, if the snapshot will be running on the backend, that's your question, right?
Yes.
Okay. See here. So this is a web server one, right? So from the web server one itself, we created a snapshot. So now I am terminating the web server one. See, web server one is terminated. Let's go ahead to check volumes web server 1, web server 2, volumes are deleted. That's normal. Okay. Go to snapshots. Snapshot is deleted. No. So,
no.
Snapshot is independent from the instance. Volumes are dependent to the instance. So, if the instance is removed, the volume also removed. But snapshot is not removed. EMIs is not removed. But EMI is depending to the snapshot. Without deleting the EMI, we cannot delete the snapshot. Got your point?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
So next, lifecycle manager. Okay, schedule and manage the creation and deletion of EBS snapshots. Okay. So create a snapshot lifecycle policy. Create a snapshot lifecycle policy. So whatever the snapshot we are creating, like instance snapshot or volume snapshot, you can take a snapshot schedule level. Okay? Schedule level. So I'll give you example. Okay. Description. Volume snapshot for web server 3. What is the name we can take it here? Web server 3. So policy schedule. Policy schedule. When? Run policy every 12 hours. So what will happen? Every 12 hours at exact the time of 9 o'clock, snapshot will create. Example, now the time is 1953. So 1953, right? 1955 I'll give it. Okay, 55 or 56 I'll give it. Okay, so retention type. What is the retention type? What is meaning a retention type? So the data will be deleted after some days. Okay, so example, 20 days I'm selecting. Okay, so after 20 intervals, days, the data, the snapshot will be deleted. Why we are deleting frequently? Any reason? Unnecessarily, billing will be charged in your account. So do you have any tax? You want to create it? You can create it, no issues. Do you want any IAM role? You have to dedicate it for creating this role. Because IAM rule, why you required means, example, unnecessarily someone was coming and creating this rule every 20 days, every day, the 12 hours, the data will be taking snapshot. That will be big problem for you. So policy summary, this policy will create snapshot tag volumes every 12 hours starting 1956. The snapshot will be retained for 20 days. So now policy will be I'm creating. So I don't know the timings, even example 1955. So whether the time will be matching or not, I'm also confusing that. Okay. So there's a UTC time, whether it'll work or not, I'm also confusing that. Let's modify the snapshot policy. UTC time now. 2:25 p.m. So sorry. So I change the policy. So time issue, we will see. Even I never used this option previously. Or else I'll do one thing. So today, I will not delete the instance number 3. There's a web server number 3. So I'll leave it as is. Understand? So the previous snapshot, I will delete it. So next tomorrow, so we will check that the snapshot is created or not. Okay. So the timing is, I'm so much of confused. So what timings it is used in this console here. Okay. That we need to check that.
One thing I'm going to ask.
Yes, please.
It will create the image by itself too.
Sorry?
So once the snapshot created automatically with the lifecycle manager.
Uh-huh.
So it will create the image?
No. It will create only snapshot. So example, there is a web server tree. On daily, you have to take a two snapshots with a 12 hours of interval. So will you able to do that every day at the same time?
No,
right? So that's what we are scheduling that work. Okay. So might be, I think this schedule will be next to 12 hours will be working. I think I'm thinking like that. Okay.
Okay.
So at present, the 12 hours is not completed, right? So might be.
Yeah.
So once you create a next 12 hours, it will be working. I'm also thinking for that. So if I leave it as it is today. So let's see the snapshot will be creating or not. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, fine. So please do not create and leave it for more than one day. Okay. Unnecessary, it will be bill charged in your account. Okay. Every 12 hours means 30 GB. After one day, it will be charged for 60 GB of storage unnecessarily for you. Okay. So please, once you are doing that, after one day, you have to keep on check volume, snapshot, EMIs very carefully. So this is a complete elastic block storage. So volume, snapshot, lifecycle manager. So any questions you can ask? So tomorrow, we have an interesting topic, IAM, Identity and Access Management. Okay. So tomorrow we will complete that one. IAM, okay. Identity Access okay. Management. And tomorrow when you're coming, so please install in your phone, either Android or iOS, Google Authenticator. There's application name called Google Authenticator. Okay.
Okay.
Please install it before. This is a Google Authenticator application. So please install it on your smartphone.
Okay.
Okay. So this is a very important for you for tomorrow lab.
All right.
Yeah.
And Mahesh, I just wanna quickly show you my account.
So yes, you can stop recording. You can stop recording then.